Hello children, hope you are doing very good. So in the previous chapter we learned triangles and we have covered five important theorems from the exam point of view. Hope you are all practicing it very well and also solve all the problems based on the theorems. Now we will move on to the next chapter, arithmetic progression. Before we understand what is arithmetic progression, let's go through some examples from our day-to-day lives. So here you see a ladder. So there are three rungs on the ladder. Select the rungs be 50 centimeter length. So what is happening as you go up? So the length of the rung reduces. So it could be 48. As we go up, the length of the rung is getting reduced. Here it is 46. So is there any pattern or a sequence in reducing? In the decrementing the length of the rungs, there is. We will come to that later. Now consider another example. Staircase, any staircase for that matter. Just remove the plastering. What do you see? Bricks. Bricks everywhere. So from one step to the next step, look at the number of bricks. Is it increasing? Is it increasing randomly? No, it is not increasing randomly. It is increasing, it is incrementing with a fixed difference. The difference of the bricks is fixed. So here also we see some sequence or a pattern followed. This is our first example and this is second. Consider another day-to-day life example. So you are traveling in a taxi or an auto rickshaw. What is the fare that you pay for the taxi? For the first kilometer, if it is 25, this is a fixed amount. For any taxi or auto, it can be any amount. Here I'll use it as 25. The first 1 kilometer, it is 25 rupees. So the next additional 1 kilometer, the taxi wala would add 10 rupees. And it is subsequently he is going to add 10 only. It is not going to be 20, 30. For the first 1 kilometer, it is 25 rupees. For the next additional each 1 kilometer, he is going to add 10 rupees. So, what could be the series of fares? 25 plus 10, 35 plus 10, 45 plus 10, 55 and so on. Is there a sequence followed here? So the difference between the numbers or the terms is fixed. It is not random. Random increment is not happening. So in all these three, these are the examples in our day-to-day life we see. And now we will understand why we need to understand arithmetic progression. We will see the same thing in numericals. Consider natural numbers. So we all know natural numbers. So it starts with 1, 2, 3, 4, it goes endless. And how is endless represented with the three dots? So what is the difference between one number to the another one? It is 1. The difference is 1. From 2 to 3, it's 1. 3 to 4, it's again 1. So here you see that natural numbers are incrementing sequentially. So natural numbers also fall into a particular sequence or a pattern. Now consider a set of even numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. Here the first number is 2 and the second number is 4. The difference between these two numbers is 2. The difference between the second and the third term is 2. The difference between the third and the fourth is again 2. So there is incrementing, the numbers are incrementing sequentially with a fixed difference. Now consider the set of odd numbers. If it starts with 1, 3, 5, 7, it goes on, and the difference between the preceding and the succeeding term is 2. Similar to even numbers, the difference between the numbers is 2, which is a constant, and here it is also incrementing. And consider these set of numbers. It's a random number, but it is a set of only fours. So what is the difference between first term and the second term? Zero. Second and third, zero. Third and fourth, zero. So there is a sequence. What is the sequence here? The first number is added with zero to get the second number. Second number is added with zero to get the third number. So all these examples follow a set of sequence or a pattern. And this is what is called as arithmetic progression. What is arithmetic progression? The definition is, it is a list of numbers where a particular term is obtained by adding the fixed number to the preceding number. So for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is an arithmetic progression. We can say that it is an arithmetic progression. Why? Because a number, how was the second term 2 is got? How can we obtain 2? By adding a fixed number to the preceding number. The preceding number is 1. We add 1 plus 1 to get 2. How do we get 3? We add 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So this fixed number, there is one fixed number which is added to the preceding term. So this is called as arithmetic progression. And that fixed term, what do we see in other examples also? Here the fixed term was 10 rupees. And here the fixed length was 2 centimeters. So all these are called as common difference. Common difference of AP. In short, arithmetic progression is referred as AP. And common difference is denoted as D. And the first term of the sequence, the first term of the arithmetic progression is represented as A. And what is the term A and what is the term D? A is the first term of the sequence, and D is the common difference. So with these two values, we will be able to write the AP. Yes, we will be able to write the AP when A value and D value is given. So this is problem from exercise 1.1. When the values of A and D is given as 10 and 10, can we write the AP? So the first term will be A. The second term will be A plus B. The third term will be A plus 2D. It goes on. So here, for this example, the first term is 10. And what is the value of D? They have given it as 10. So we will add A plus D. 10 plus 10, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. 30 plus 10, 40, and goes on. So this is the AP for the given problem. So with the values of A and D, we will be able to write the AP. This is the second example. Here, A is minus 1, D is half. So always be sure, children, we need to subtract the second term from the preceding term, not A1 minus A2. It is never A1 minus A2. It is always A2 minus A1. So this you need to remember. So here in this problem, A is minus 1, D is half. So what is the required AP here? The first term you should always write the value of A, that is minus 1. The second term will be A plus D, that is minus 1 plus D is A2 minus A1. But what we need to write is AP. We don't know the AP. If AP was given, we would take the second term minus the first term. Here we need to write the AP. Therefore, A plus D minus 1 plus half. The next term will be the value of the preceding term plus D. So we will first find out this value. Minus 1 comma, we will take the LCM here. Minus 1 and this is half fraction, so we will take LCM. So here it is minus 2 plus 1, which gives minus 1 comma minus half. So we have got the preceding term as minus half. We will add minus half plus, what is the value of D? Half. So what is minus half plus half? Zero. So we got the three terms. This is an infinite AP, so we can represent it with dots, which is endless. We know the number of terms. So what is the AP result in? Minus 1, minus half, and 0. We go to the next main exercise 1.1. Here you need to identify whether the given series are in AP, that is in arithmetic progression. Which of the following a1. The second term minus the first term, which is 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. This is for the first condition. What about the second? Whatever the home, if there are 4 terms, we need to find out the common difference till the 4th term. So we will find out a3 minus a2. a3 minus a2 gives you 8 minus 4, which is 4. This is the first one, the second one, and this is a4 minus a3. That is 16 minus 8, which is 8. So what do we see here? The common difference is not a constant value. Therefore, since a2 minus a1 is not equal to a3 minus a2, it is not equal to a4 minus a3. Therefore, we can say the above series is not an AP. Is not an AP. We can write arithmetic progression in short as AP. We will take the next example. Here you see root, they are irrational, set of irrational numbers. Root 3, root 6, root 9 and root 12. And it goes on. So first step is we need to write A. That is the first term, which is root 3. Our next step is to find out B. That is A3 minus A2 minus A1. What is the value of A2 minus A1? Root 6. Be careful with irrational numbers. Root 6 minus root 3. I have always mentioned children how to consider an irrational number just like the way you treat variables. Like this is x and this is y. So root 6 minus root 3 will be root 6 minus root 3 itself. We cannot subtract. They are unlike terms. So go to a3 minus a2. This is the third term. a3 represents third term. a2 represents second term. Root 9 minus root 6. Root 9 is a perfect square. We can write it as 3 minus root 6. Root 6, we cannot, it's not a perfect square. We have to retain it. We have to retain it as root 6 itself. So the answer here is 3 minus root 6. We will go to the next set. a4 minus a3. a4 minus a3's fourth term is root 12 and a3 is root 9. 12 can be written as 4 into 3 minus, this is a perfect square, 3. So 4 comes out of the root as a 2. 2 root 3 minus 3, they are unlike terms, so they remain as 2 root 3 minus 3. So compare the values. Root 6 minus root 3, 3 minus, they are all unequal. Therefore, we can say a2 minus a1 is not equal to a3 minus a2, it is not equal to a4 minus a3. Therefore, they do not form AP. And this condition is important. If you don't write this condition, we cannot conclude that whether it forms an AP or not. So next we will move on to what is finite AP. Consider this example 2, 4, 6 and 8. There are no 3 dots, which says it is endless. There are only 4 terms. So the number of terms is definite. So we call that as finite AP. So you can guess what is infinite AP. Here the number of terms, consider the natural numbers. It starts from 1 and it is endless. So here the number of terms are not definite. They are called as infinite AP. Now we will move on to the next section, which is nth term of the AP, which is very important in this chapter. What do you mean by nth term? Consider the series of AP. If A is the first term, how do we get the second term by adding the common difference, which is D, denoted by D? How do you get the next term? A plus D plus D, which is nothing but 2D. A plus D plus D plus D, which is nothing but 3D. We can reduce this to A, comma A plus D, A plus 2D, A And what will be the last term? Last term will be, we will add the first term plus n minus 1 into d. This will give you the nth term of the AP series. This is very important. Therefore, it is denoted as an. We represent the nth term as an, and its formula is a plus n minus 1 into d. So we will use this formula in solving the problems. We will go to the exercise problem. Find 10th term of AP. Whenever you see 10th, 3rd, 4th, so we should apply the formula an. Why? Because an gives you that particular term's value. An is given by a plus n minus 1 into t. They have asked for 10th term. So what is n? 10. So a 10. And the first value is 2. 2 plus n value is 10. 10 minus 1. And what is the value of d? D will be a 2 minus a 1. 7 minus 2, which is 5. Substitute that value here. And that means 2 plus 10 minus 1 is 9. Into 5, that gives you 2 plus 45, which is 47. What is 47? It is the 10th term. And we can represent the 10th term as A10. So, nth term is An, so 10th term is A10. We'll move on to the next problem. Which term of AP? This is the AP. It is 78. Here, in this chapter, we have An formula and SN formula. There are only two formulas, but the problems of what you see is going to be different. But we will go around only with these two formulas. We just have to substitute D value, A value, and An values. So which term of AP? AP is given, and the value of that term is given as 78. And this 78 is nothing but An. Which term? That is, we don't know the value of n, but we know a value. So first, write down, as soon as you see an AP, write down the values of a, d, all the inputs that can be written from the AP. A is 3, d is a 2 minus a 1, which is 8 minus 3, 5. So we have the value of 5, d. We have the value of a. We have the value of an. So we can use the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So here you write we have an's general formula. This is. So what is the value of an? Just we substitute the values, inputs. 3 plus n we don't know. We need to find out n. And substitute the value of d. That gives you 3 plus n minus 1 into 5. 3 we will take it to the left hand side. It becomes 78 minus 3, which is 75, is equal to n minus 1 into 5. We will bring this 5 to the left hand side. It is 75 divided by 5. That is equal to n minus 1. And this gives you 5, 3. N minus 1. Therefore, n is equal to 13 plus 1, 14. Here, 75 by 5 is 15. So, n is 16. So, what is this value? What we have asked, which term of AP is 78? 16th term of AP will be 78. Therefore, here n is equal to 16. I send you this as an assignment. I'll give you this table. And this table will contain four columns which says A, D, N, and AN values. And you will see the blanks here. And fill in the blanks with the question. So you need to fill this blank with the help of AN, the term of the arithmetic progression formula. What is that? AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Using just use this formula, substitute the values, get and fill the blanks. Here A value is given, D is given, M is given. A, D and M is given. A and is a pair. Here A is not given. D, M and A is given. Substitute and fill the blanks. You will have more questions in this table. So it will be sent to the lab. Now we will move on to the fill in the blanks. Look at this blank. Look at this series. Here you don't see those dots here. That means it is a finite series. Finite series of A. And it has 1, 2, 3 terms only. So n is equal to 3. And A is, as soon as you see an AP, what did I tell you? First, note down the inputs. A value is 2, n is 3, and we don't know B. We don't know An. Do we know An? Yes, we know An, which is the last term, 26. What we need to find out the middle term? With the help of this formula, A plus n minus 1 into D. An value we know 26, A is 2 plus N is 3, 3 minus 1 into 3 minus 1 is 2, D value we don't know. We will find out D value from this. 26, 2 we will get it to the left hand side, it becomes 24, which is 2D, and D is 24 by 2, which is 12. With this D value, can we find out the middle term? Yes, we can. How? First value is A and the second value will be A plus B. That is our A2. Therefore, A2 is equal to A is 2 and the D value is 12. Therefore, A2 is 14. You can fill this box with 14. We will go to the next question. Here, we have two blanks. We don't know the first value itself. So, here you write A as question mark. Do we know N? They are finite series. So, our N value is fixed here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do we know D? We don't know D. We don't know. Do we know An value? Yes, An is 3. Here, when you don't know two variables, A and D, we have to solve the linear equation. So, we will get the linear equation, two variables. We need to solve that and get the values of A and D. How do we get it? How do we get the second term? A2 is nothing but A plus D. A plus D. What is A3? A plus 2D. What is A4? A plus 3D. This is a general form. So we can apply these things to the given series. A2 is given 13. So A plus D is equal to 13. We can take one equation. What about the third one? We don't know the first term, we don't know the third term, we don't know. But we know the fourth term, that is A4. So we will take this equation and A2 equation and substitute the values. What is A plus A2? A2 is 13 from equation, and then we will name this equation as 1 and 2, from 1 and 2. 13 is equal to, we don't know A. We also don't know B. From the second equation, do we know A4? That is An. We don't have to mention A, An, because it's finite series, so we can take it directly as A4, 3. 3 is equal to A plus 3D. So we have learned linear equation with two variables in the 9th class. Is this a linear equation with two variables? It is. So how do we solve it? We can subtract. So to eliminate one of the variables. How do we subtract a linear equation or any algebraic expression? We change the signs. Okay? So plus A minus A gets eliminated. 13 minus 3 will give you 10. And D, that is plus D, plus 1D minus 2D gives you minus 3D plus D. Minus 2D. Therefore, D will be minus 5. Be careful with this minus sign. So, D is minus 5. Once you get D, we can get A from this equation. We can substitute. I'll do it here. Substituting. D is equal to minus 5 in equation 1. Therefore, A plus D, a plus b is equal to a 2 is 13, a is equal to 13, d place we can substitute minus 5. But this d when it comes to the right hand side it is minus d, minus of minus 5, which is 18. We got the value of a. Once you get the value of a and d, it's easy to get the first term and the third term. First term is our a. So a is 18. We can fill this 18. What about third term? We have the formula, we have the equation here. A 3 is equal to a 18 plus 2 into d. 2 and d is minus 5, which is 18 minus 10, which is 8. So the third term is 8. So fill this in. We will move on to the next one. This is a word problem. As soon as you see the word problem, just take out the inputs of a, d, a value, n value from the word problems. So Subbarao started work in 1995. So don't worry about the year here. At an annual salary of rupees 5000. So the initial value is 5000. So which is our a value. And receive an increment of rupees 200 each year. Whenever you see increment, decrement, it goes into our common difference value, which is d. So every year it was incremented by 200 rupees. So d is 200. Starting salary is 5000. In which year did his income reach 7000? So we know the final value, which is a n, 7000. In which year? So we don't know the value of n. We have the formula, nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. We know the final value of, what was his income. At the end of which year we don't know, but we know how much he was getting at the end of that year, particular year, which is 7000. And the initial salary was 5000 plus n minus 1, we will retain it because we don't know the value of n, and 200. 7000 minus 5000, 2000 is equal to n minus 1 into 200. Here, this is the simplest way of solving it. I don't want you to multiply 200 with n and get a linear equation. No. Keep this to n minus 1 on the right hand side, bring 200 this side. Therefore, you will get 2000 divided by 200. You can solve it as 200 n minus 200. You tend to do mistakes, so I want you to do it this way only. 2000 divided by 200 is equal to n minus 1. So this is easy. So 10 is equal to n minus 1. N is, bring the minus 1 on the left hand side to the 10. So it is 10 plus 1, 11. On the left